We have five current research projects that deal with concussion. They are all approved by UF Athletic Association and UF IRB. The first one that we began with was a blood test study. We were trying to develop a test for some proteins that you find in the blood after a brain injury. We wanted to see if these can be detected in a concussion type injury soon after the event. We've got over 200 athletes enrolled. They're with our football, women's soccer, and women's lacrosse teams. And we draw their blood prior to the start of a season. If they get a concussion, we do blood testing again. And we look to see if these proteins are elevated after the injury. The second study that we're involved with now is an imaging study where we do advanced types of magnetic resonance imaging on athletes also at baseline, so before they start their season. Then we do it after a concussion. We image them again, and then we do one at the end of their college career, and whether that's 3, 4, 5, 6 years, or however many it may be. And that also involves football, women's lacrosse, and women's soccer. And we've picked these sports because they have the highest incidence of concussion at the University of Florida.
With our imaging study, we're performing MRI examinations, magnetic resonance imaging, on some of our Gator athletes. If we can find evidence of prior injury to their brain from prior sports participation, we actually have the players play a game. It's centered on athletes. We're showing them different athletic balls that they would be used in various sports and ask them to memorize them.
Our third study is creation of a data bank. We can store de-identified data on all of our concussion testing in all of our athletes. So it's every sport. We test cognition, symptoms, balance, some vestibular function, and we can put that in a data bank. Over a couple years, we hope to get thousands of data points that look at things like how long does it take them to recover, how many concussions they'd had prior to coming to college, and see if those line up or to what position they play. Our fourth study involves a particular test called the King-Devick test. It's a sideline test for concussion where an athlete reads screens of numbers, and they read them and we time how fast it takes to do it. It was initially developed for dyslexia, but we found that it's also helpful in concussion. It's a very quick test, takes about 30 to 50 seconds, and athletes find it easy to understand and it's easy to interpret their scores.